We learned, bottom line, in our research, people do not quit organizations. They quit bosses. If you're having a really high turnover, look in here. Interesting study. Just came out from the Society for Human Resource Management. They asked 2,600 white-collar workers across North America to name one leader in their organization. 85% of the people they named as leaders did not hold management positions. Isn't that amazing? 85% did not hold management positions, which says every person in your organization can be a leader. You cannot mandate customer service. Do you agree with me? You cannot mandate it. You can't threaten, you can't cajole, you can't reward. It's got to come right from here. And that's the theme of this conference, the passion of customer service. So I want to give you some ideas to take back to your folks to help them to have that passion so that they choose to serve the customer. And so ask yourself, write that question down. Am I contagiously enthusiastic about the work that I'm doing? Because folks, if you are, it shows. It really shows.
Barbara Glanz is the author of several best-selling books focusing on employee motivation and retention. With a master's degree in adult learning, Barbara, known as the employee motivation expert, has diligently researched the hundreds of practical ideas for creating and maintaining a joyful work environment, as well as balancing our corporate and private lives.
Story about how one person can turn a whole organization upside down. Reason for being, having a sense of purpose or mission that you are important. If we can take that back to our employees, we are going to change the way they feel about themselves, the way they feel about their jobs, the way they feel about our world. I was asked 5 years ago now to speak to 3,000 employees of a large grocery store chain. They brought everybody, the truck drivers, the busboys, the cashiers, the produce people, everybody. I talked a little bit about the idea of adding a personal signature to your work. What can you do to put your special touch on things? Well, I always give my audiences my home phone number. You have it on the front of your handout. I want to hear from you. After I had spoken, about a month went by. I had a phone call one afternoon. It was from a young man. He told me that his name was Johnny and that he was a bagger in one of the stores. Also told me in the conversation he was a person of Down syndrome. He said, Barbara, I liked what you said. He said he went home that night and he asked his dad to help him with the computer. He said they set it up into three columns, and he said every night from that night on when he goes home, he finds a thought for the day. He said, if I can't find what I like, I think one up. Then he and his dad type it 6 times on a page. They print out 50 pages every single night. He cuts them out, signs his name on the back, and the next day, for every person's groceries he bags, he puts a thought for the day in the bag. Now, about a month later, the store manager called me. He said, Barbara, you won't believe what happened today. He said, when I went out on the floor about 9:30 this morning, the line at Johnny's checkout was 3 times longer than any other line. He said, I went ballistic. I was yelling, get more lanes out there, get more cashiers, customers, lines open. And he said, the customer said, no, we want to be at Johnny's lane. We want the thought for the day. So he said, who do you think is the most important person in this whole store? Now, most of us would say that isn't a job that's very important, but he made it important. The manager said one woman came up and said, I only used to shop once a week, but now I come in every time I go by because I want the thought for the day. What happens when you go in the store? Yeah. 3 months later, he called me back again. He said, Barbara, you and Johnny have transformed our store. Said, now in the floral department, when we have a broken off flower, an unused corsage, we used to just throw them away. So now they go out on the floor and they find an elderly woman or little girl, and they pin it on them. So one of our meat packers loves Snoopy, so he ordered 50,000 Snoopy stickers. Every time he packages a piece of meat, his meat gets a Snoopy sticker on it. Now I said, I don't know about dog stickers on meat. But he said, we are having so much fun, and our customers are having so much fun. And that spirit in the workplace started with one little God. The manager called me last February, end of story that you do not know. This is a little bitty store in the Midwest. I don't use the name or location because Johnny's parents have asked me not to. They just won the award for the very best store in the entire United States. And we know why. My belief is, if little Johnny can do it, there is no reason why every one of us in this room can't do it.